All right, great to be here, Ralph. Thank you. What's that next great opportunity? And what I'm talking about today is the space of smart cities. A smart city connects people, it connects processes and assets. It creates efficiencies and improves sustainability. Think about the fact of efficient water and efficient energy use. It also has the opportunity to reduce operational costs. Think about street lighting, efficient road maintenance, and more. It encourages economic development. You think about if you're the smartest city, right, you can bring in more business, you can have more growth. And most important, it will simply make people's lives better. We've invited, as Ralph said, a phenomenal, incredible group to help us talk about this. So ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome first Hans from Ericsson, Jessica from the FCC, Brian from Intel, and Mayor Reed from the city of Atlanta. Hello. I told Mayor Reed to dress down. This is his dress down, by the way. Yeah. So I'm gonna start with a question for all of you. Hans, I'll let you kick us off. So introduce nice. Yourself to this wonderful audience, and please describe how you define smart city.
Okay, my name is Hans Vestberg, I'm the CEO of Ericsson. At Ericsson, we believe in the networked society. Anything that benefits from being connected will be connected in the future. And of course, what we are doing in all that is, of course, building the technology, the infrastructure, but also the softwares all around it. As we see it, the majority of all the initiatives in the smart cities right now is around public safety, energy, utilities, and transports. There where you get the early wins, and I think Glenn talked a lot about it. We are working with turnkey projects in all of them all around the world. And I think that's our way of working with smart cities and enable all this connectivity.
What role do you play in the implementation of smart city initiatives?
Well, at the Federal Communications Commission, we think a lot about networks. And in particular, we think a lot about wireless networks because
Yes, that's
good.
That's good. That's good. That's good stuff.
Glad to hear it.
That's good stuff.
Because how we zone our skies is a ticket to understanding our future. And the smartest cities think about how to use wireless spectrum to provide smarter services for their citizens. So I think what we need to do is make sure that we take more of our airwaves and make them available for commercial and municipal markets, because when we do that, we will decrease the cost of access to digital wireless services, and we will increase the likelihood that cities can experiment with it in new and innovative ways.
Glenn, I think our job is to lead and to be an example so that this technology can be scaled faster. If you want to do something in Atlanta, which is one of the largest cities in the country, you need me and 8 votes on city council. So from a speed perspective, I think you'd rather meet with me than to go to Washington, right?
Yeah.
No. But I think that what we need to do is to have an example, and so that these uses can be replicated faster. And I think the way the country is going is more and more business leaders are going to be engaging mayors, because you're able to bring your idea in, get a fair hearing, and then we're going to need to partner with businesses like AT&T, because many cities don't have the bench strength to execute and implement on all of the available data.
How can municipalities break through the financial barriers that exist at trying to put in smart cities? So how's Mayor Reed? How's he going to get help, payback, et cetera? What's your thoughts on that?
I actually think it's going to take people like the three of us, you and I and Hans, to look at business models differently. I do think that if you look at the cost of the infrastructure and the implementations, it could be daunting. But as Jessica just said, there's advantages, solutions we're going to provide, and those solutions will not only do things like reduce commute times and lower, you know, energy usage and sustainability, it will lower cost. And so what we need to do is look at business models that then say, tell you what, we'll go put in this infrastructure at cost, but we want a percentage then of the cost savings, not of, you know, additional spending or something, but of cost savings we're able to provide for the next number of years. That's how we'll get paid. We'll get paid on the back end of these things. I think that will then really allow cities to do this at a much, much faster rate. And it's going to take that creativity and investment on our part to make that happen.
Everybody, please give our panelists a round of applause.